The day one, we started this Star College in 1969, when we're receiving government grant one-to-one. And once we upgraded to university level in 2012, we got an agreement with government, a maximum of 60 million grant from government. Unfortunately, lately the government has suspended the allocation, which I think is very uncalled for, because as you know, there is agreement between TAR-UC with government. It has nothing to do with MCA or DAP or whatever parties. The party is between government and TAR-UC. So government have to fulfill this obligation. This has to be done, I mean, in a professional way. Because when we run TAR-UC, it's in a professional way. We are running an education institution. It's for the benefits of the people in this country, irrespective of race and creed, and also in the background. So what I'm puzzled and also very upset, that this has been, TAR-UC has been the victims of this situation. You know, TAR-UC has been turned into somebody's way of victimizing us. So we would like to express our concern, and I must thank the public, because the public come forward and supported us. The public, today they have their fundraising on their own initiative, because everybody know that TAR-UC is doing a good job, and we are actually helping our students here. And whatever fundraise is for the welfare of the students, is for the future of our student. So I think a government need to fulfill the obligation. It's for the good of the nation. It's for the good of our younger generations.
马来西亚人民，特别是华裔同胞，在过去50年，我们不断地把这间大学的这个数字呢提升到今天的这个地位。我们在会计，在这个很多领域呢是跑在最前面的，是世界公认的。 是一个非常高素质的大学学院。今天我们提供这个电商，也是跑在前头。我们跟中国最先进的大学合作，那么来提高马来西亚的这个电商的这个水平，跟这个领域的发展。所以我认为我们尽量把我们的工作做好，我们非常负起责任，非常专业的来做。所以请不要牺牲拉曼大学学院。
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.